He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
So let's go ahead and work through some conversions using Avogadro's number. The first question asks, you have a 5.0 kilogram brick of pure gold. How many gold atoms are in the brick? And the second question asks, you have a 40.0 milligram sample of saccharin, which has the formula C7H5NO3S. How many carbon atoms are in the sample? So we're asking about numbers of atoms. That means we're going to need Avogadro's number. So if this is confusing, go back and check out my tutorial on the mole and Avogadro's number, and that should clarify a few things. And when you're ready, go ahead and give these a try. So let's take a look at the first one. Remember, we have a 5.0 kilogram brick of pure gold, and we want to know how many gold atoms we have. So naturally, with any conversion, we're just going to start with the value that we have. The only information we have is 5.0 kilograms. So how are we going to convert this? Well, first of all, we want to get this into grams, because whenever we're using molar masses and things like that, we're using grams, not kilograms. So we need to go from kilograms to grams. So let's multiply our value by 1,000 grams over 1 kilogram. That will cancel out the kilograms, and now we'll have a value in grams. So what's next? We have grams of gold. We have a number of grams of gold, but we need moles, because moles tell us about numbers, and the question is asking us about a number of gold atoms. So we need to go from grams to moles, and for that, we need the molar mass of gold. And so we can look that up on the periodic table. That is 196.967. So we're going to put one mole over that many grams, because we need grams on the bottom so that grams will cancel. And now we have a value in moles. We have the number of moles of gold atoms. And now that we have the number of moles, which is a number, we're going to use Avogadro's number to get this into the number of atoms. So for however many moles of gold atoms we have, we simply multiply by 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd atoms over 1 mole, because those are equivalent. Avogadro's number is the number of items of any object that are in 1 mole. Those are equivalent. That is the definition of a mole. So now moles will cancel, and we have a value in atoms, or number of atoms. So we can just go ahead and plug these into the calculator. We have to multiply everything on the top. So that's 5.0 times 1,000 times 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd. And then we divide by everything on the bottom, which in this case is just 196.967. Now here's a tip. If you think this feels a little complicated because of the 10 to the 23rd, what we can do is just enter in all of the other values first. So in your calculator, do 5.0 times 1,000 times 6.022 divided by 196.967. Just do all of that first and click enter. And that will give us 150, and now we can multiply that by the remaining 10 to the 23rd. So that simplifies things a little bit. Now remember, this is an appropriate scientific notation because we need one digit followed by a decimal place. So we're going to have to adjust this until we have 1.50. So we can go by powers of 10, but every time we change our value, we have to change the exponent above the 10. So if we go from 150 to 15, we just made that 10 times smaller. So we have to make 10 to the 23rd 10 times bigger. That's one more power of 10, so we go to 10 to the 24. If we do it again and we go from 15 to 1.5, we've made that 10 times smaller. So in order to keep the magnitude of this value the same, we have to also get 10 times bigger somewhere else. And so we increase the power of 10 by 1, and we have 10 to the 25. So that is our answer. This is 1.5 times 10 to the 25 atoms. Now moving on to the second question, we have our 40.0 milligrams of saccharin, and there is the molecular formula, and we want to know how many carbon atoms are in there. So this is very similar to the first question. Let's approach it the same way. We have 40 milligrams, and once again, we want that in grams because all of our molar masses that are going to enable us to convert into moles use grams. So let's multiply by 1 gram over 1,000 milligrams. We need milligrams on the bottom so that milligrams will cancel and we are left with a value in grams. Now we can multiply by 1 mole over 183.18 grams. That is the molar mass of saccharin that we can get by adding up 7 carbon atoms, 5 hydrogen atoms, 1 nitrogen, 3 oxygens, and 1 sulfur. If we take the atomic masses of those and add them up, we get 183.18 grams. That is the molar mass of saccharin. And so by doing this and by putting grams on the bottom, we get grams to cancel and we are converting into moles of saccharin. Now, once we have moles of saccharin, that is a number. And so in order to get the number of molecules, we just need to multiply by Avogadro's number. Avogadro's number works for atoms or molecules or tennis balls or anything because a mole is a number and it implies that there are Avogadro's number worth of objects in that sample. So if we have some number of moles of saccharin molecules, then multiplying by Avogadro's number will give us the number of molecules that are in there. So we multiply by 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd molecules over 1 mole. Moles will cancel. And once again, if we do 40 times 6.022 divided by 1,000 divided by 183.18, we will get this number and we can leave the 10 to the 23rd separate once again. But now we do have to get the decimal place just to the right of the 1. So if we move the decimal place and get 0.0131, we have made that 10 times bigger. So we also have to make it 10 times smaller by decreasing the exponent on the 10 from 23 to 22. We can do it again to get 0.131. So that's 10 times bigger. So to also make it 10 times smaller, we go from 10 to the 22 to 10 to the 21. And then we need to do it one more time. So 1.31, once again, we have made that value 10 times bigger. So to simultaneously make it 10 times smaller and keep the value the same, we have to go to 10 to the 20. So we have 1.31 times 10 to the 20 saccharin molecules. So we're almost there, but remember the question asks how many carbon atoms are there, not saccharin molecules. So we take our number of molecules and then we just have to multiply by 7 carbon atoms per molecule because each molecule of saccharin has 7 carbon atoms in it. So however many molecules we have, we need to multiply that by 7 to get the number of carbon atoms that there are. So molecules will cancel out and we end up with 9.17 times 10 to the 20 carbon atoms. And that will be our answer for this question.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.